Did you know your eye color isn't really a color at all? Your iris isn't painted like a canvas. What you see is light bending, scattering, and reflecting through tiny amounts of pigment. That pigment, melanin, is the same chemical that gives color to your skin and hair. When light enters the eye, it's focused by the cornea and lens, then passes through the pupil, whose size is controlled by the iris to regulate light intensity. The melanin level in your iris matters because it determines how much protection your eyes have against UV radiation. Too much exposure without protection can damage the retina and even cause blindness. This is why people in the tropics, where sunlight is intense, developed darker eyes, while in icy regions like East Asia, ancestors evolved darker, narrower eyes and monolids to shield against snow glare. Meanwhile, in Northern Europe, where skies were dim and cloudy, light eyes appeared, since there was less need for built-in sun protection. That is why eye color diversity is most common among West Eurasians, whose ancestors stayed in West Asia during the Ice Age before spreading and reshaping Europe after the Ice Age during the Neolithic and Early Bronze Age. Now let's explore each and every eye color one by one. Blue eyes carry one of the most fascinating origin stories. They began with a single genetic mutation near the Black Sea about 6,000 to 10,000 years ago. That mutation silenced part of the OCA2 gene, reducing pigment in the iris and letting light scatter to create the illusion of blue, like the sky itself. Every blue-eyed person today can trace their lineage back to that same ancient ancestor. The first known population to carry this trait were the Western hunter-gatherers of Europe, who, despite having dark skin, developed piercing blue eyes. In the dark forests and cloudy skies of Ice Age Europe, blue eyes may have been useful by allowing more sunlight absorption for vitamin D, and they may have also improved low-light vision for hunters and night watchers, helping them track prey or guard against predators like cave lions. The downside, however, is that less melanin means less natural UV protection, making blue eyes more sensitive to glare and sun damage. Still, they became iconic. Their shades range from icy blues that look almost translucent, to deep ocean blues that swirl with gray or green, to smoky steel blues that carry a cool, stormy haze, to soft baby blues as gentle and pale as a clear morning sky, to bright sapphire tones that shine with a jewel-like intensity, and even aqua blues that shimmer like turquoise waters in sunlight. Today, blue eyes are most common in Northern and Eastern Europe, but they are also widely found in Southern Europe, the Balkans, the Caucasus, Central Asia, West Asia, and even in North Africa. Brown eyes, on the other hand, are the original human eye color, the default of our species. Early humans in Africa lived under harsh sunlight, and brown eyes, rich in melanin, gave powerful protection against UV radiation. This natural defense was so effective that brown eyes became the most widespread and enduring color in human history, and still dominate globally, with more than 70% of people having them. For our African ancestors, brown eyes were especially vital. They allowed people to see clearly in bright, sunlit environments without being blinded by glare, and they made it easier to spot dangerous animals lurking in the bush or hiding in the tall grass. The advantage of brown eyes is clear: strong sun resistance, sharper vision in intense daylight, and healthier protection for the retina. The trade-off, however, is that they don't have the same low-light benefits as lighter eyes. But brown eyes are far from simple. Some are so dark they look black, offering the strongest protection. Others glow warm like milk chocolate, shimmer golden like honey, or radiate amber with a solid golden glow. Hazel brown eyes mix multiple tones, while ash brown and starburst patterns add unique smoky or golden variations. Brown eyes are found across Africa, Asia, Australia, and the Americas, and even remain common in Europe despite the rise of lighter shades. They are, in every sense, humanity's oldest superpower. Green eyes are the rarest of all common eye colors, appearing in only about 2% of the global population. They are not truly green, but a blend, more pigment than blue, less than brown, with light scattering adding a jewel-like glow. This unusual balance requires several genes interacting, which makes every green-eyed person unique. Green eyes likely appeared in Europe as populations mixed after the Ice Age. They offered no clear survival advantage, but they stood out as rare and striking, which may have played a role in sexual selection. Culturally, green eyes often carried associations with magic, mystery, or even danger. Their shades range from bright emerald that shines like gemstones to muted olive greens with earthy undertones to hazel green mixes that shift between colors depending on the light. Some are pale and mint-like, while others are deep forest or hunter green, glowing with intensity. Green eyes are most common among people of Celtic or Germanic ancestry in Northern and Central Europe, but they also appear in Southern and Eastern Europe, parts of West and Central Asia, and North Africa. Amber eyes tell a different story. They are among the rarest shades in the world and owe their glow not only to melanin, but also to pheomelanin, the same pigment responsible for red hair and freckles. This combination creates a golden or copper shine, sometimes with an almost metallic glow. Amber eyes may have evolved randomly with no major protective benefit, but their rarity gave them an almost animal-like allure, reminding people of wolves, cats, or eagles. Shades include pure golden amber that glows like honey, deep copper with reddish tones, fire opal amber with orange warmth, citrine lemon amber that looks pale and luminous, and honey amber that softens into caramel warmth. They are extremely rare worldwide, appearing in less than 0.1% of people, sometimes linked with certain types of albinism. Seen across scattered populations, amber eyes remain unforgettable for their wild, glowing beauty. Hazel eyes are the chameleons of the human spectrum. Their story is one of variety, created by uneven melanin distribution that shifts color depending on lighting and surroundings. They don't offer any strong evolutionary advantage, but they symbolize diversity itself, often appearing in populations where different ancestries mixed. Their shades are endless. True ambergreen hazel with two distinct tones, autumnal hazel leaning brown and warm, forest hazel with mossy greens, gold-flecked hazel bursting with yellow around the pupil, tricolor hazel with three distinct rings, and bronze hazel that glimmers metallic in sunlight. Hazel eyes are most common in Europe, North Africa, and West and Central Asia, but appear worldwide thanks to migration and blending populations. Their shifting nature gave them a reputation for mystery and unpredictability. Gray eyes are among the rarest, with less than 1% of people having them. They likely developed in northern climates as a variation of blue, where extremely low melanin combined with dense iris fibers flattened the scattering into a silver glow. Gray eyes share the same disadvantage as blue. They are sensitive to sunlight, but they also share the benefit of improved low-light vision. What makes them unique is their silvery quality, often appearing otherworldly. Shades range from icy silver gray that looks crystalline to steel slate gray like storm clouds to blue-gray lagoon shades that shift outdoors to green-gray tones with faint, earthy undertones. Some gray eyes look smoky and neutral, while others appear cloudy and soft like morning fog. A few even carry amber flecks near the pupil. Gray eyes are most common in the Baltic region, Eastern Europe, and Russia, and are almost non-existent outside Eurasia. Their rarity and metallic shimmer make them feel like windows to another world. Red and violet eyes belong to the rarest human category, usually caused by albinism. With almost no melanin, the iris becomes translucent, and the blood vessels inside show through, creating a red or pink glow. In some cases, scattered light mixes with this, producing violet or lavender shades. These eyes don't offer evolutionary advantages. They come with disadvantages like extreme sensitivity to sunlight and vision problems. But culturally, they became symbols of mysticism, saints, demons, and even vampires. Their shades range from vivid ruby red to deep amethyst violet, and even electric magenta that glows under certain lighting. Though extremely rare, they can appear anywhere in the world among people with albinism. Finally, there are eyes that break all patterns. Heterochromia. Sometimes one iris is completely different from the other, or a single eye contains two or more colors. This can be genetic, caused by uneven melanin distribution, or result from injury or illness. Complete heterochromia means two entirely different colored eyes, while sectoral heterochromia creates a patch of color inside one iris, and central heterochromia adds a golden or amber ring around the pupil. These striking variations were often thought of as mystical, with some cultures believing such people could see both the human and the spirit worlds. Today, eye color isn't just biology, it's identity, beauty, and even technology. Modern beauty standards have turned rare shades like green, gray, or blue into global trends, fueling billion-dollar markets for cosmetic lenses and even risky eye color-changing surgeries. But here's the truth. No eye is ever just one shade. Every color lives on a spectrum, shifting with ancestry, with light, and even with perception. So instead of ranking beauty, it's better to see eyes for what they really are, living mosaics of the human story. And if this fascinated you, don't forget to check out my other videos on skin color and eye folds. As always, stay curious, stay smart, and thank you so much for watching.